In Syria's greater Idlib, Hayat Tahrir al-Sham continues its attempts at rebranding, all the while keeping up its usual militant activity. As per the Russian Reconciliation Center, militants in greater Idlib shelled the surrounding areas 32 times on April the 6th. Another al-Qaeda-affiliated militant group in greater Idlib, Ansar al-Islam, posted photographs of its activities in Idlib province. The footage showed the work of terrorist snipers targeting the Syrian Arab army. This is more than likely a tool to show that the Damascus government cannot impede their activities and serves as a recruitment method. The Russian aerospace forces continue responding to all violations by striking militant positions. On April the 6th, an air raid was carried out near the settlement of Bazankul in Idlib. In spite of the Damascus government and Russia's attempt to deter the militants, the United Nations sent 88 trucks of humanitarian aid to Syria's Idlib. The aid is supposed to be distributed among the needy people in Idlib and its surrounding areas. It is more likely that it is being used by Hayat Tahrir al-Sham and other militant groups to consolidate their grip on the region. In addition to countering the activities of the greater Idlib factions, the Syrian Arab army, with its Russian support, is containing ISIS in the central region. In the 72 hours leading into April the 6th, the Russian airspace forces killed at least 29 ISIS terrorists in their strikes. A large number were heavily wounded. These attacks were centered on the Hama province and stretched all the way to the border of the Deir Zor province. Still, limited ISIS operations continue. On April the 6th, one civilian was killed, several were injured, and a large number of citizens were abducted in the town of Al-Sa'an in the eastern countryside of the Al-Salamiyya region in Hama. The terrorists ambushed government forces who were protecting the civilians. In total, 19 were abducted. Out of them, 11 were civilians. ISIS minefields also remain and need to be cleared sometime in the future. On April the 5th, a civilian was killed and another injured in a blast at the Bowera site on the Jabal Abu Rajmin road north of Palmyra. The United States profits from chaos, wasting no time in smuggling resources away from the local population. On April the 5th, according to Syrian media, US forces smuggled out a convoy of trucks loaded with wheat stolen from the silos of Tal Alu in Yarubiya in the northeastern countryside of Hasaka. Additionally, on the very next day, Washington's troops smuggled out a further convoy of 34 tanks and trucks carrying stolen quantities of oil and wheat, also from the Syrian Al Jazeera region, into northern Iraq. Every party involved in Syria is fighting tooth and nail for their own interests, and any small opportunity is being exploited, as it is clear to see.